day 14, and as you can see, we have a beautiful flower. These have three petals, and there are a lot more flower buds, particularly in the one where the flower came from, which was closest to that light over there. You know, those look big and ready to burst open. The leaf growth has been, you know, somewhat underwhelming in my opinion. Be sure to check out my sunchoke and sweet onion series in the backgrounds with their new setups. The tuber has shrunk a little bit. I had to readjust it. It's sort of falling into the cup a little bit every day. And this root system has really come along. As you can see, all that molecular oxygen just sticks to the roots. And the root system overall has just become a lot more hairy and robust. The new stuff is all this pale virgin white. It's really nice. And you have these particles of fertilizer pellets that, you know, just kind of do this falling down. Only the white ones do that. So that provides a little bit of stirring action too, but it's nice to have these fertilizer pellets in there because they keep reacting with the hydrogen peroxide and that generates a continuous fizzing of molecular oxygen. So that stirs everything up and, you know, provides the roots with the oxygen they need. They don't need carbon dioxide. All right, it's day 15, and there are multiple flowers in bloom, probably hundreds more on the way. So each one of these flowers has male and female reproductive organs, one carpel and four stamens, as far as I can tell. It'll be really hard for you to see. And if you look down here, I sprinkled a bunch of this Miracle-Gro Bloom Booster flower food. Since it seems like flowers will be a main attraction of this series for quite a while. So this has less nitrogen than the regular Miracle-Gro singles and a lot more phosphorus in it. And some other trace elements as well. Boron, copper, whatnot. So this is distilled water. I've already poured this beautiful blue powder in there. And I'm going to pour some water in it. Now it has occurred to me that the tuber might have been shrinking this entire time due to being exposed to the air. So I'm thinking about that because in my sunchoke series, I'm soaking the whole thing now in a nutrient solution and it's doing really well. The tuber has really swelled up in volume. So, you know, I've already got the fertilizer pellets in the bottom. This is a really heavy dose. You know, maybe it'll go well, maybe it won't, but, you know, we'll see what happens over the next few days. Hoping that this really helps out the tuber by having it mostly immersed. So this is some hydrogen peroxide. And that should do the trick. All right, it's day 17 of this Korean radish series. As you can see, there are many, many flowers in bloom. That bouquet that I just first showed you was the prettiest one. Currently, they have four petals, kind of a purplish on the outside. Turn off a light or two so you can get a different perspective. And get this light off. So yeah, it's more clear if you do this. But you get the idea. And there are four stamens, one carpel. You know, the leaves are still this medium size, not very big. Let me turn the lights back on. So the tuber is no longer green on much of the top half. And I tried immersing this. It doesn't seem to have expanded. You know, I've kind of taken it up and down for a ride. Seems a little bit more tight. I do think this is actually sucking up water. I stand corrected. So I'm going to add more water. I had an over-fertilization problem. First of all, I would like to say, you know, when this thing turns cloudy, and it seems like for all three of my series, the water turned cloudy at first, that's because of mold. And once you dump that out and add some fresh hydrogen peroxide, that solves the problem. I mean, these roots look really, really healthy. Let me focus on them. And you want a lot of hydrogen peroxide to keep that bubbling. Of course, it helps to have those fertilizer pellets, but you don't want to over-fertilize like I did before, where it was far too blue with that bloom booster. So what I did was I poured half of that out in the sink, and then I started adding some water and hydrogen peroxide until the color changed. It was still pretty blue yesterday, but you want that equilibrium point in which I think the blue color gets absorbed by the plant, the nutrients, within 24 hours.